You know what's happening now, Afwan Akhia? What's happening now, people are looking for any excuse to dictate to Allah, you know? So one of the arrogant statements, some people maybe say out of arrogance, some people out of being deceived, that, oh Allah, why you create me? Allah is your creator. You like it or not, He's your creator. That's what we have to learn. Sometimes I've noticed some brothers, they start looking for this philosophical way, you know, giving analogy, no problem, give analogies. But also you have to make it clear, Allah is the creator, you are a servant of Allah, follow Allah's teaching. Allah never ask you, ask those questions. You want to ask questions and reject Allah, then Jahannam for you. If you know, look at this hypocrisy, yeah? They say, if Allah created me, and He knows I'm going to go how far where He created me. Okay, are you created? Okay. Do you believe in Allah? Okay. And you believe if you go and get Him, go to hellfire? Yes. But also, He created you. If you follow Him, you go to Jannah. What? Yes. Okay. So why don't you follow Him?
Stop.
You see the hypocrisy? So basically, he wants to be a kafir billah, but he wants to control Allah. So my brothers, give analogies. It's good. But some analogies will not suffice no one. Especially this question. This tough question, if Allah created me, why is He going to take me to Jahannam? Okay? Wait, so you know Allah created you. Look at the contradiction. You know, Safsata, this cross of history, yeah? This, what you're doing, you want to be a kafir, but you want to comfort your soul because you have a nafs al-lawwama. La uqsimu bin nafsi al-lawwama. What is a nafs al-lawwama? Every human being has this soul that blames him and reminds him of his purpose, of his creator, to comfort himself. And to cover it, so he start looking for any excuse to justify his disbelief. But if this miskin, this brother or sister who are having this doubt, step back, think, you know what? I've already accepted Allah as my creator, but He also created me to go to Jannah forever, which is I will do everything in Jannah. So why do I not follow the teaching of Allah? And I know I'm going to go to Jahannam, but I still go and guess him, so he deserves to be in Jahannam. That's how you're treated. No safsata, nothing. Subhanallah. You are a servant of Allah. Allah created you. Allah said to you, you've been created. Worship Allah and you go to Jannah. That's it. But what some people want Allah according to their desires. They want to dictate to Allah how we should run His creation. Then what I would say to you, start looking for any silly arguments, any philosophical, nonsensical excuse. Know for sure that you will die and stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And tell Allah, on Yawm al-Qiyamah, Yawma yafirru al-mar'u min akhih, wa ummihi wa abiyih, wa sahibatihi wa baniyih. The day when the people start, people start running away from each other, when people are scared, when a severe day, that's when you start having have a gut, say, oh Allah, why you create me? That's when you regret. Yawma ya'addu al-dhalimu ala yadayhi. يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا يا ويلتى ليتني لم اتخذ فلانا خليلا لقد اضلني عن الذكر بعد اذ جاءني وكان الشيطان للانسان خذولا. On the day when a person will bite his own hand out of regret, he say, I wish I followed the way of the prophet. I wish I never told that person as my best friend, because he misled me from the truth after it was clear to me. So we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All this argument that you hear it, wallahi, this is an argument from the arrogant ones who are arrogant and they know they should worship Allah, but they start looking for any excuse to reject Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sometimes what happens to some Muslim brothers who give da'wah, they start entertaining it. No, they not entertain this nonsense. Just show them the double standard and the hypocrisy. And the contradiction of this question. Is that clear? What is the second question? I mean, I don't like to be... I'm here to learn, inshallah, teach you and to learn. Yeah, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. I just want to mention about the importance of a prayer, the salat. You know, we have to learn what is our purpose in this life. Our purpose to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And worshiping Islam doesn't mean you go in a mosque every day, don't come out of it. No. Looking after your mother is worship. Working, making money is worship. You know, taking care of your wife is worship. Taking care of your children is act of worship in Islam. However, the prayer is very important. What I've noticed, many brothers come here, ask about the Muslim leaders, Saudi or Kuwaitis or Algerians. When you ask them a simple question about prayer, they have no clue. And they say, don't make it personal. Yeah, but you're talking about the leader's problem. It's personal, that's his business. You understand? Yes, we enjoy good, forbid the evil, but I'm in Britain here. I need to enjoy good and forbid the evil myself and my family first. Then we'll move on. So, how many brothers out there, sisters out there don't pray? Did you know that after reading, I'm leaning toward the strongest opinion that the one that does not pray is kafir? And he should not be buried, the scholar said he should not be buried with the Muslims. So why don't you pray? And as Ibn Taymiyyah said, the one that does not pray is arrogant. It's mutakabbir, because if you are humble, the best aspect of humbleness is to be humble to your creator. How to do it through actions? When you pray. You understand, akhi, when you pray. If you want to manifest humbleness to Allah, by praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not because in need of our worship, because we are in need of worshiping Him. When you do not worship Allah, you'll be lost. You're just following desires. That's my advice to you. May Allah bless you all. We ask our sincerity. And another time, inshallah ta'ala. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Barakallahu fikum.